Hello and welcome to this video. In this video, I'll be showing you the new version of Compare Data Workbook, which is version 3. This particular version has now detailed instruction, as you can see, which is in the first tab. You must follow this instruction, otherwise this workbook may not work and it will not give you correct analysis. I'll be explaining you step by step how to use this workbook and what to do and what not to do while working with this workbook. This is the first step after instruction. This is called old data. Basically, this workbook compares two similarly structured data set and gives you the variances in form of add, remove, and change data. So in this particular example, I have this employee details, which has ID, full name, company name, gender, and job title. Now we have this old data. Suppose this data is for the previous month, and this is the new data, which is for the current month. It has similar structure of data, as you can see here, ID, full name, company name, gender, and job title. So one of the fundamentals of using this workbook is to have a similarly structured data. So here we have column A to E, and here in new data also we have column A to E. Now we want to see exactly the difference between these two data. So what has changed from this data, that is old data from last month to current month? How do we know that? And we also want to know what has changed in each cell. So not only added and deleted data, want to also know changes which has happened from last month to this one for this particular data. So in this particular sheet, which is called variance, I'll delete this existing analysis and I will click this compare sheet button. Now analysis has been done with the macro. As you can see here, there are two employees which have been removed from the new data with compared to old data. So these two employees are not there anymore, which were here in this particular data set, which are not here anymore. So they have been marked as removed. This particular employee has a change in the role. So it now has a finance manager role. We'll see what the role was for this particular employee. And all these employees, which are total 12, as you can see here, count 12, have been added in the new data. So let's see one by one whether this data analysis is correct or not. So let's take this first employee, which is Gilbert, which is a male and an internal auditor. And this employee was there, but I don't think so it's here. And that's correct. So this employee has gone. And the second employee is Madinal. And let's see whether Madinal is there in the old data. Yes, in the row 6. But it's not there in the new data. There is a Medina, but there is no Medinal anymore. So that's correct. And this particular employee, which is Havel, is particular data for this particular employee has changed in this cell, column F, and this particular cell, which is a job title. So let's go to old data and let's see this particular employee. Yeah, here. Havel was a senior financial analyst. And in the new data, if we find Havel here, he is now a finance manager. So this particular employee has been promoted and we can see here. And all these employees have been added. Right from this Adelaide till West, all these employees are new. So this is basically what this analysis is showing, this particular workbook does for you, which is a fantastic. If you try to do this traditional Excel formulas function like VLOOKUP, index and match, you can achieve this, but it will require a lot of formula knowledge, and the formula itself can get very complex and a big mega formula, which is difficult to audit and later on understand if somebody else uses it. Instead of this kind of macro enabled workbook will be the best solution. Now I have additional three tabs here, as you can see, which is added data, remove data, and variance data. Let's try to copy the same. So I'll click this button, copy variance data, and I'll see what happens. Yes. Now we'll go to each of this tab. Now added data, which is this 12 rows, have been copied here with the add tag. Remove data, which is here. This two row have been copied here. And the change data, which is row 5, which is for Havel, have been copied here with the exact same title. Now with these three additional tabs, you can do more analysis and create more reports or dashboard the way you want. Now let's go through step by step and understand this each and every button and what not to do and what exactly your data should be while using this Compare Data Workbook. Now let's start with old data. So first button is clear sheet data, which I will clean the data here. So if I click here, and it will ask for whether you really want to delete it. And if I click yes, and the data is gone. And second button, this one is for copying the headings to all these sheets. As I mentioned before, the structure should be same all the time. So in order for that, I have created this macro, which will select range like this. It will go and it will go like control shift right like this. So whatever the data is till the end, it will select and it will copy. It will come here. It will paste it here. Now, if you have additional data already here, you need to make sure that you remove it manually by clearing the content like this, clear content, and just remove the formatting accordingly. So for example, if I add here email like this and just copy the format, and now I click here, copy headers to all sheet. If you come here, you'll see in the new data sheet, the email column has come. Similarly here in variance data, the email column has come. So, but if I want to remove this now, like this, I will copy the format from a blank cell and press delete. And if I again press this button, it will keep this particular email here. Why? Because the macro goes to the right by selecting range A2 and moving right. This way it selects the last non-empty cell, which is job title here. So in this particular scenario, you must go here and do like this, copy the format and delete it manually. Now in new data sheet, the button clear sheet does the same job. So if I click here and I click here, the data will go away and now you can paste new data. And in variance sheet, clear data sheet button does same thing. It will clear the data. And this is most important. You need to delete or clear your data with this button before you do a further analysis. So if I press this compare data sheet again, it will pop up an error like this. So we want to avoid that. So let's clear the data like this. Now compare sheet does the same. It will compare the data as I showed before. Now we don't have any data here now. So that's the reason I cannot press it. It will not show anything. And copy variance data copies the data into individual sheets. So the first step would be to paste your data in a similarly structured format. And then clear this exit analysis, because you might be using this workbook for some other analysis as well. So in that case, you need to remove this data with the help of this button, clear data sheet. Similarly, in these two sheets also, if you have any previous analysis or previous data which you were using it for analysis, you need to clear it with this button. And why you need to do this button, I'll explain you in a moment. So coming back to instruction. So the first instruction is that do not delete any columns. Do not delete any columns at all. Otherwise, this workbook will throw up an error, the VBA code error. So make sure you don't delete that. And better if you want to remove the column, as I showed you before, you need to clear the content, select the column like this, right click, clear the content, and also clear the formatting. Now you can delete the rows, but except this third row, which is right after the header. So the macro works from the header and starts from there. The first row should never be deleted. And also you need to make sure that all the data which you bring in this workbook has to be already cleaned up and all the settings and deletion and addition has been done. So don't try to delete anything after you paste the data. That's the important point. You can still delete manually like this before you bring in the data. So just if there was any analysis previously done with this workbook and you just copy this workbook for another analysis, you can still go and delete the data. But then again, I already created this button for the same. So don't try to delete rows, especially the first row, unless it is really necessary. Now, if you would like to change the names of sheet, old data, new data, and variance, you can do that also. So for that, you need to go to developer tab and go to Visual Basic, or you can press Alt F11 shortcut key. So you have to come here in this particular code, compare data main code, double click it, and you can select this particular text old data, which is the sheet name of your old data. Let me minimize this, like here, old data. And then we have new data, which is exactly same. and then variance. So you can change it here. Once you change your sheet names here according to your liking and your choice, you must go here and copy paste exactly same information. Similarly, you can also change the tags added, remove and delete here in this particular area. So for change, you can put something else like variance, remove you want to put instead of remove you want to put deleted, and added you want to use something else like addition or some other word if you want to use. So you can do that. Now the background color, like I have earlier mentioned, was red for deleted data, completely red background. So that you can change it here in this particular section. So for remove data, I have a background color of RGB 255 00, which is nothing but a red color, a dark red color. And then I have a font of white to contrast it. And then I'm making it bold. Don't want bold, you can make it false here. And also here you can change the code of RGB, which is easy to find online also. And accordingly, you'll get the colors you want. So this is for the remove data. And this is for the change data. Similarly, you can change the background color, font color, and also the type of font you want, bold or something else. And this is particular area is for the added data. So this particular changes you can do, and make sure apart from this, you don't do anything at all. You don't touch anything at all. Otherwise, this code will not work. I have provided test instruction. As you see, I have provided this comment there to change the sheet names or the tags of add, remove or delete. Background color can be changed, as I mentioned. Now, since this particular workbook and the analysis works by row and by cell, you need to ensure that data set has a key column. So in this particular example, we had a employee ID or employee code, anything. So that particular column needs to be there. That is called key column. So if you have a stock data, if you're trying to compare any other data, it needs to have both data needs to have a key column, which identifies the uniqueness of data. So in next point, I'm mentioning in point 6, data set must have a unique entries of data. So you cannot have a repeated data. So you cannot have two employees having same number. You cannot repeat them. So you need to have a unique data. So if you want to do analysis, you need to extract data in such a way that your key column content, the rows and the data set has a unique identifier. So for example, an employee number has to be unique. You cannot repeat the employee number, and accordingly the data shouldn't be repeated in either of the new data or old data. That is important. Now I already explained you the buttons. So that's the explanation here. And most important thing is that data type should be same. So for example, let's bring in the data back, which I was doing, and I'll come back in a moment. Now I have brought back the data as we were working before. As I was mentioning, if the data set and the data type is different between old data and new data, this analysis may show you a wrong result and not up to your expectation. So for example, if in this particular data set, Mr. Howell, I put two spaces, that means there is a trailing space, and let's go to new data and Howell doesn't have any space here. So it's correctly formatted, I should say. And I clear this and try to compare here. I will have a change data here, which you can see here, which is not correct. I can see there is a change here in the data for the full name as well. As previously mentioned, which Howell had was promoted as a finance manager, who was also was finance manager. And now he was, now let's run this macro again and see what happens if the data type is not same, exactly same. So in this example, Howell, we put two spaces, right, in the new data. That's why the full name particular cell, full name column in this cell is showing as a changes, which is not correct. Why? Because the name is same, as you can see here, the name is same. Only problem is that there are two spaces here in his particular data, in this old data. So you have to be careful that you clean your data properly. So you need to be, so you need to ensure that your data set is correctly formatted, especially after your ID column, which is your key column. So all the data should be properly formatted. So if there are some trailing spaces or your particular number is stored as text in old data, but it is correctly stored as a number in the new data, the variance and the compare data macro will pick it up as a changes. So these are the precautions you need to take care. If you have any question regarding using this workbook, the free support is available. And you can contact me on my email ID as mentioned in the description. Also, where to download this workbook, as you know, you have to click the link in the description and you'll go to the download page there and you can download this workbook. I'll be creating a full-fledged course on Udemy, how to exactly use this particular workbook in a real life scenario. I'll be doing a case study of a detailed payroll analysis of a particular company, where I'll be creating hundreds of employees data, their payroll sheet, their pay sheet data with 1 month to another, and show you how powerful this particular analysis can be with the help of this Compare Data Workbook. So that course I'm developing currently and it will be available soon. Subscribe to my YouTube channel here and hit the notification bell so you won't miss that particular video, the announcement video when it comes out. The course will have a free copy of this workbook available readily. So if you don't want to get this workbook now, you can hold on, and when you enroll into the course, you will get the free copy of this particular workbook. So thank you so much for watching. If you have any question, please let me know in the comment section below, and you can reach out to me to my email address. And once again, the link to buying this particular workbook is in the description.